the cost of not transitioning is so much higher than the cost of transitioning.
COP26 is so important. We need to talk about money and the role of money, investing in companies, and how our money can drive the transition to a net zero world.
It's great to see the private sector be part of COP. It's the first time, really, where the private sector has been much more involved. And the private sector is influential, and it's important to getting us to our goals, particularly the Paris Accord of 1.5 degrees.
Chief executives need to be focusing on the near-term goals of achieving net zero, but also need to recognize that climate shocks, the floods, droughts, heat waves are taking place today, and any investment needs to be resilient to those shocks.
Some of the work that we continue to need to do is to think about reporting, how we can standardize reporting, how we can make data more available to organizations, to individuals that have been tasked to address some of these challenges. We also need to work on disclosure standards to address concerns around issues such as greenwashing.
Here at COP26, there's some progress being made, but we've got to do much, much more. We've been campaigning on pensions in the UK. Now some 800 billion in assets under management are now committed to be aligned to net zero, but it still leaves around 2 trillion in pension schemes that haven't made that commitment. And that's why we've been calling on the UK government to make net zero mandatory for pension funds.
The financial sector can certainly help as well. Asset owners, asset managers, they have to be very focused on investing in sustainable type companies, and that is happening, I'm seeing it happen. But I also think it's a transition. So many people are saying, well, financial services companies shouldn't be investing in oil or in coal. There has to be a transition. And I think if we're not careful and we don't allow that, we will have many problems between now and 2050.
If we don't incorporate just transition considerations into the investment structures, into the products, into the financing vehicles that we develop, this won't work. We have to take society with us. The purposeful nature of it means that it's tremendously powerful for employees, for stakeholders of organizations much more broadly. So it is very clearly everybody's business.
As leaders, we need to be ruthlessly focused on achieving our net zero goals, not in the far distant time, but right now, every year, throughout this decade. It needs courageous, bold, and collaborative leadership, working with the sorts of partners we've perhaps not been used to working with in order to achieve that goal.
The whole world is going to align to net zero, so you need to seize the new commercial opportunities that that transition will create, but also get on board so that you can compete in that context.
I balance hope and concern, but also recognise the seriousness of the situation that we're in. We haven't got time to lose, and we have to channel our fears into action, because from our actions will come the hope that we can deliver.